Hello everyone. I've had requests to subtitle my videos, but I don't have the time or the technical know-how to really do that right now. So I'll be including a transcript of the video as a document below in the info box. I'm sorry if you get a low budget feel from this video. I don't really have any good recording equipment of my own to use, and I need to try and invest in some better gear. Anyway, on with the show. I wanted to start with something that was high energy, exciting, and implements a unique instrumentation. Of the big film composers out today, Hans Zimmer is one of my favorites. He is fantastic at relaying a lot of energy in music, and isn't afraid of pushing the envelope. His music often sounds very edgy and massive, which sets it apart from a lot of older generations of soundtrack. For a completely different feeling, I suggest you listen to the soundtrack to Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. The music has a great organic form with odd amounts of measures and different phrases, and that pleasant piano melody that almost sounds like it could be mood music for a Pixar film. I say the lax, lighthearted feeling of the music is very good at capturing the innocent vibe that a lot of the movie has. Like with number 7, I haven't actually seen the Battlestar Galactica series, but judging from reviews, and with my knowledge of the soundtrack, I really would love to watch it eventually. This piece really draws me in. There are some moments that are so regal and light, and then that happens. The end of each phrase pulls out a special spacey chord, a major flat 6 chord, which is also used in Zimmer's Interstellar. The writing of this passacaglia is masterful, and it influenced the writing of my own passacaglia quite a bit. One doesn't need to say much about Polymorphia. It's a truly terrifying work. It calls for a 40-piece string orchestra and over a dozen techniques that radically change the sound of the ensemble. One can hear shivers, rumbles, moans, screams. Penderecki is one of my favorite composers of all time, and this piece exemplifies his ability at writing non-tonal music so well. I included this also because the mood it sets for that iconic scene in The Shining is truly awe-inspiring. another Zimmer work on the list. Hopefully people don't think I'm being too biased. I think even if the sprawling, lengthy, and sometimes monotonous Interstellar can't hit all audiences, surely the music can. One of the harmonic motifs in this inspired a large-scale work I've been working on for about 2 years now. It's a mini opera. Without Zimmer's masterful imagery and forward momentum, I feel like the gripping moment when they were attempting to dock the space station would not have been the same. His usage of pipe organ is equally striking and defines the entire soundtrack, and arguably the amazing ability of him as a composer altogether. Besides the fact that The Shawshank Redemption is literally my favorite movie of all time, I've seen it 15 times, I am entranced by Newman's classical approach to the score. His classical composition, with its heartbreaking melody and bass ostinato, set an austere mood, fitting of someone condemned to an unjust prison sentence. The whole score is perfect, really. The moment when he frees himself from the sewage pipe, the mysterious music that seldom played when a big, surprising scene would occur, when Andy was finally able to be with his best friend at last. Newman captured all the right moments in the soundtrack. This is probably one of the most underappreciated scores I know. The movie alone is thrilling and tragic, and is beyond a shadow of a doubt my favorite role Robin Williams ever performed. The score implements harp, celeste, and orchestra. Stand alone, this ensemble sounds like it would have been dainty and light, but the harmonies driven in here, especially in the second theme, give a very raw energy. The celeste is the anchor, but it's also that sense of loneliness. I can't think of a lonelier instrument. The harp propels the ensemble with its running arpeggios. The orchestra is the heartstrings, with its hard-hitting melodies and lush orchestration. I'm going to include a lot of time of not speaking so you can just enjoy this beautiful writing. Thank you. hope everyone enjoyed my little presentation. I've gotten some requests to do a list-based video, and I admit I had a lot of fun compiling this. If you'd like to see more, please let me know in the comments. Next time I might discuss my favorite lesser-known classical pieces, or my favorite twists in classical works that people don't generally talk about. This is Evan Bennett, an American composer. Happy listening.